This is Getting On With Life, Biblical Wisdom for Successful Christian Living, and this session is titled, Overcome by Evil. Most of us would not think of ourselves as being able to be brought under the power of evil, or of a demon or evil spirit. If someone accused us of coming under such power, we would feel deeply offended and react with indignation. We might think of ourselves as having weaknesses and tendencies that we are not proud of, such as speaking with a sharp tongue, getting annoyed, being drawn to immoral thought or talk, and so on. We most likely excuse those to some degree as maybe a besetting sin or an area where we reflect the negatives of our upbringing. However, the Apostle Paul, in the Bible, gives Christians a clear instruction to not be overcome by evil. In Romans 12:21, he says, "Be not overcome of evil, but overcome evil with good." So, whether you like it or not, it is possible for Christians to be overcome by evil. To be overcome means to be conquered or subdued. That is to say that evil has somehow put its foot on us and pinned us down, making us serve it. But it also suggests that we've allowed that to happen, as in having submitted ourselves to some unholy impulse of evil. Some people are subdued by being conquered in battle. They've resisted the attacker, but been too weak to fight off the attack. Yet others have been tricked or pressured into giving in when they could have kept resisting. It seems that Paul is speaking to Christians about that second case, where, for whatever reason, a Christian gives in to evil instead of resisting it. That might be by such things as giving in to temptation, accepting an unholy idea because it somehow appeals to their personal values, or allowing pride or self-righteousness or the like to cause them to be unkind or hurtful to others, so not reflecting Christ. I came across a rather graphic picture of someone overcome by evil in the biography of Australian woman Fiona Beasley, preserved for such a time as this. Fiona's account gave me a fresh awareness of how people can yield to evil. I recently met Fiona and discussed what she had gone through. Fiona was raised by a non-Christian mum who had a bunch of her own issues. As a girl, Fiona often saw dark figures around her, which she identified as demons. On one occasion, seeing the room full of these creatures, Fiona reacted and screamed. One huge demonic figure was particularly intimidating. Fiona's mother rushed into the room, angry at Fiona for making a fuss. Fiona continued to react as the huge demon continued to threaten her. Suddenly, Fiona saw the huge demon slip into the mother's body, and the mother began beating Fiona mercilessly. Fiona regained consciousness in her mother's arms as the mother sobbed for what she had done to her child. That's a tragic situation, and Fiona recognizes that her mother had mental illness issues. At the same time, it suggests a picture of Fiona's mum suddenly being overcome by an evil presence, causing her to take far more drastic abusive action than the mother would have intended. That account reminded me of situations where people react unreasonably or over the top, as if someone had pressed their buttons and set them off. Sudden outbursts of anger or pride, bragging, outlandish behavior, fits of depression, violence, abuse, lust, greed, lying, terror, etc., could all be situations not far removed from what Fiona saw as a child. One day, my brother teased a school classmate about how weak the boy was, and the boy immediately fell to the ground and began doing push-ups. I watched in horror as the boy kept going, obsessively, until his face was bright red and every muscle bristling. We tried to tell the boy he had made his point, but somehow the boy was no longer in control of his body and was playing out a painful act as if possessed. I dare say that young man was overcome by something, probably related to pride, in that startling moment. Being overcome by evil doesn't have to involve such dramatic invasion of evil into a person, but it does involve Christians allowing evil to rule them instead of Christ. Paul makes another reflection of people's love for God being overcome by other choices when he wrote to Timothy about helping young widows. In 1 Timothy 5:11, Paul says, "Do not put younger widows on the list of widows, for when their sensual desires overcome their dedication to Christ, they'll want to marry again." It's not a sin for widows to remarry, but the widow ministry comprised women dedicated to prayer, not to starting a new life. What is significant here is that people can make a vow of dedication and have that overcome by personal interests. That's being overcome by evil. There's much more to say on this topic, which I'll get to at a later time. Right now, consider the example Fiona's biography provides, and consider if you need to find God's help. You may well need to employ the weapons of spiritual warfare and get help from your Christian support team, such as church and spirit-filled believers, if you recognize any pattern of you being overcome by evil. God bless you.